My name's Aidan. I'm 21. I'm from Wisconsin, so I know the area. And I've got 1 year left at school, where I'm studying philosophy. That's really it with me. I'm a runner. I run for the team at my school. Looking for two things this summer. You know, I wanted to spend my summer, one, just, you know, outside, you know, in nature, somewhere where I could, you know, connect more with the outdoors. School, you know, it's just a lot of, you know, studying in the library. And two, I wanted a place where I could make, like, some genuine connections with people. And the special need aspects of Camphill, I didn't expect it, but it's actually been really meaningful.
Yeah.
I've definitely made some great connections. So those were my two compasses, trying to find somewhere, and I just found this place, and it seems like it would fit, so. I know my way around kitchens. I've worked in a couple pizza restaurants, and, you know, we have a pizza meal here every Friday. And the first time I got here, nothing against the guy who was doing it, but, you know, I'm somewhat of, you know, a pizza snob, I suppose, having worked in a couple restaurants, one of which was, like, you know, what you might call, like, artisan pizza. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I asked Angela if I could, you know, help out with that, and then it turned out that he left, and so then I kind of just took the reins. And yeah, it's been one of my favorite parts of being here. Thanks a lot. You know, I really have always liked, you know, making food for people. I think it's one of those ways that you can just, you know, put time and effort into something that people can enjoy, kind of an expression of love in a way. And yeah, I've always felt that cooking and food was, you know, a really great route for that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I've never really worked in a garden like this. You know, I've never had access to a variety of vegetables and fruits, and it was really great. You know, I just generally eating here and eating this food, you know, I've having been there when it was, you know, small like little saplings, and now this huge garden, that's just kind of changed my whole relationship to eating the food that we grow here. And you know, of course that extends to the pizza that we make, especially because, you know, we can even make our own tomato sauce. And, yeah, it's made the process. I mean, it's great. It's great food, first of all, like great crops, but generally, just like there's that other aspect of, you know, knowing that you helped grow this and cultivate it that makes it taste that much better. Like a natural kind of thing. You know, there was just three or four of the villagers, you know, Monty, Nicole, Dee Dee, and sometimes John, but though it's just them three. And, you know, as I've been here, I've just gotten close with all three of them, and so it wasn't really like a situation where it's like, you know, like we're working and you're like, I'm do this, I chop this. It wasn't like that. It was kind of just like I would write out all the things we'd have to do, and we would just slowly get them done, and you know, talk with each other. But 3 hours, which is what we have to make the pizza, you know, that's a lot of time, and so it gets done, and there's usually not any stress, and it's fun. Yeah, there are so many ways that experiment with pizza and different things that, you know, fill that time. Mm-hmm. But yeah, that actually, you know, running the workshop was very natural. Mm-hmm. Something that I found challenging was, you know, being out here in Sauk Center. It's a lovely place, but, you know, it's just very far removed from, you know, my life apart from this place. And, you know, I purposefully didn't bring any kind of technology to connect with, you know, that other part of my life. So, you know, I came in knowing that that would be a challenge, and a challenge that I wanted to pose to myself, you know, just being out here, you know, with some books and some beautiful land, and trying to make use of my time. And so that's been a challenge, because hasn't really been boredom, but there's been you know, times where I felt like I've missed that kind of world that I'm gonna go back to soon. But I really think being apart from it, to the extent that I was, has been really healthy for me. So that's surely been a challenge. You know, I feel like, you know, I've been journaling a lot while I'm here, and I think the greatest gifts that Camphill, Minnesota has given me are just so many, like, really sweet, small moments that I have with coworkers or villagers they're just, like, small, you know, maybe just, like, a weird joke that somebody makes, or, you know, somebody has a funny outfit on. You know, the villagers are so quick to laughter and so intense with their laughter that there are just so many of those moments where it was like a small joke, you know, it wasn't anything, but just like Dee Dee or Nicole would just erupt with laughter. Mm-hmm. And I'd find myself like smiling after those small moments for so long, because I just, they're so beautiful, and those have been gifts, and gifts I hope to remember, to look back on. I mean, being a land intern and working so much with the garden, I do think I have a newfound connection to eating, and specifically just that wider perspective on, you know, the life of a plant and all the care, cultivation that goes into it, but also the abundance of, you know, like you help it grow, but then it, you know, just provides so abundantly. And you know, I think that lesson that I suppose nature, it's, you know, it's abundant, you know, it's providing so much. I think I really hope to take with me, you know, being more mindful of the products that I consume, and maybe having my own small-scale garden, or even, you know, just a couple of herb plants on my windowsill. But yeah, a real connection to what I eat, and, you know, the care that goes into what I eat. That's surely a lesson. I would say that, you know, coming here, you know, when I got here, you know, there's a lot of different faces, a lot of new faces, and a lot of people who are really averse to social interaction. There are some who are just like, get so much out of it, but there are also the villagers who are very averse to it. And, you know, the process of being here and slowly kind of getting to know them, and, you know, building some kind of relationship that's possible, has just been incredibly rewarding, like more so than, you know, most of the relationships I've built in my life. And I think that just generally is teaching me to, you know, meet people on their level, and have patience, and I think those, yeah, those relationships that I've built here, that are not by any means, like, you know, normal, like, enriching relationships, but in their small way they are, you know, those have been really meaningful, and you know, I hope to kind of take that mindset into the relationships that I've built in my future. I mean, this is a great place. I've loved my time here. And these people, the land, I hope to never forget it. And I know I will look back on it fondly. But I think one of the most special parts about this place is that it does have a steady, like, stream of new people. And, you know, so many different people get to come here and experience what makes it so special, and you know, take lessons like I have out of it. I think I can't wait for other people to have similar experiences that I've had. I would say to just really try to be as open as you can to the experience. The relationships you build, and the very different shades of people you'll meet here. I think just being really, like, daringly open to those, and compassionate, and with that openness, I think it's really easy to find so much meaning and joy.